Yes, Jim, you know, for a while there, it looked like the world was in for a disappointment as delay followed delay in the countdown, but the Falcon Heavy delivered.
3, 2, 1, ignition. Falcon Heavy.
There's enough fuel on a Falcon Heavy to equal 4 million pounds of TNT. The Falcon Heavy was originally intended to send people to the moon and to launch the heaviest kind of satellites. So it's big, and it felt big.
Well, it was kind of a new day in rocket engineering and capability. You know, that was a very large rocket.
Elon Musk, the rocket designer and entrepreneur, set expectations low, freely telling folks he thought there was about a 50-50 chance of another SpaceX explosion. But the fifth most powerful rocket ever built, and most powerful one now in existence, appeared to do its job as intended. An amazing aerial ballet followed within minutes of liftoff as two previously flown rockets separated and headed toward Earth for a historic pinpoint double landing. And off to deep space with the song Life on Mars blaring from its speakers was Musk's own red sports car with a guy called Starman at the wheel. What a ride. And we're still waiting to find out for sure what happened to the third rocket. There were three that were landing. This third one landing in the ocean. SpaceX has not yet said whether that landed successfully or not. Even if not, it doesn't really take a lot of the luster off of what happened today. Most of what happened was a first with private money. Jim?
So, Dan, that red car that's heading into space on top of the rocket, where is it going and why is it so important?
It really is more than just a kind of a promotion for Tesla and sports cars, although it is that. Right now, it's in orbit around the Earth. It's in the Van Allen radiation belt. That is a very, very serious and tough test for anything or anyone to undergo. If it can survive that, and if the second stage can survive that, it's going to fire in a couple of hours and send that car toward Mars, as far away from Earth as Mars is. It won't actually get to Mars, but it's got a little thing printed on its circuit board in case anyone ever discovers it, built on Earth by humans.
Dan Billow for us at Kennedy Space Center on a remarkable day. Dan, thanks.